गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास 11, लेट्स स्टार्ट। वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट रिडॉक्स रिएक्शंस। नाउ रिडॉक्स रिएक्शंस आर द रिएक्शंस वेयर ऑक्सीडेशन एंड रिडक्शन रिएक्शन अकर्स साइमल्टेनियसली। ओके, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिफाइन ऑक्सीडेशन एंड रिडक्शन इन टर्म्स ऑफ हाइड्रोजन, ऑक्सीजन एंड इलेक्ट्रॉन्स। सो ऑक्सीडेशन, इट इन्वॉल्व्स addition of oxygen, for example magnesium plus oxygen gives magnesium oxide. Then oxidation involves removal of hydrogen. This is the example. Okay, and the third one, oxidation involves loss of electrons. Okay, so these are the few definitions of oxidation in terms of oxygen, hydrogen and electrons. Next we come to reduction. Reduction involves removal of oxygen. Involves removal of oxygen. Example, this one. Next, reduction involves addition of hydrogen. And the last one, reduction involves gain of electrons. Okay, so these are the few definitions of reductions and oxidation in terms of hydrogen, oxygen and electrons. But as per modern concept, we have to define reduction and oxidation in terms of oxidation number. Now first we are going to discuss what is oxidation number. Oxidation number of an atom, it represents the charge. It represents the charge present in an atom of an element in its ion or when it is combined with some other atoms. So oxidation number of an atom of an element, it represents the charge of an atom in its ion or when it is combined with some other atoms. So oxidation number calculation some rules are there for the calculation of the oxidation number. So the first rule is that oxidation number of an atom in its free state or elemental state is taken as zero. For example, oxidation number of hydrogen in hydrogen in H2, sulfur in S8 and phosphorus in P4 is taken as zero. Next, oxidation number of fluorine atom is always -1 in all of its compounds. Third, oxidation number of oxygen is -2 in all of its compounds except peroxides, superoxides and oxygen fluorides. Now in peroxides, the oxidation number of oxygen is -1. In superoxides, it is -0.5. And in oxygen fluorides, we have two types of oxygen fluorides, OF2 and O2F2. So if it is OF2, then oxidation number of oxygen is how much? It is your +2. And if it is O2F2, it is your +1. Okay, next point is oxidation number of hydrogen in metallic hydrides is -1. Okay, and in rest of its compound it is +1. Next, in case of complex ion, the sum of the oxidation numbers of the atoms present is equal to the net charge on it. Okay, and next one, in case of neutral molecules, the sum of the oxidation number of the atoms present is equal to zero. And the last point under this, oxidation number of an ion is equal to the charge present on it. For example, if I talk about oxidation number of sodium or calcium, then it will be equal to the charge present on this ion, that is oxidation number of sodium is +1, oxidation number of calcium is +2, etc. So these are the few points by which we can calculate the oxidation number. And let's do few examples. For example, if it's given, calculate the oxidation number of KMnO4, means oxidation number of Mn in KMnO4. So K we know it is +1, oxygen we know it is -2, and let the oxidation number of Mn be X. So we can write 1 plus X plus 4 into -2 equals to 0, as it is a neutral compound. So X will be equals to +7. Next example, calculate the oxidation number of sulfur in sulfuric acid. So we know hydrogen is +1, oxygen -2, and so 2 into plus 1, sulfur oxidation number be X, and 4 into minus 2 equals to 0, as it is also a neutral compound. Now, X will be equals to how much? Plus 6. Next, if we talk about some ionic species, for example, nitrate. In nitrate, if it's given, calculate the oxidation number of nitrogen. So, nitrogen will be taking it as X. Oxygen, we know it is minus 2. So, plus 3 into minus 2 equals to minus 1, because your overall charge is minus 1. Okay, so X will be equals to how much? X will be equals to plus 5. So, these are the methods by which you have to calculate the oxidation number of the given atom. Now next, there are some exceptions to oxidation number where usual method is not followed. Now, for example, Fe3O4. If we calculate the oxidation number of iron over here, taking oxygen as minus 2, what do we get? Oxidation number of iron as X equals to plus 8 by 3. That means oxidation state of iron in Fe3O4, in triferic tetroxide, is fractional. Now, whenever we are going to get this fractional oxidation state, we have to consider here average oxidation number is used. Average oxidation number of iron has been used here. Actually, what is happening? This triferic tetroxide is a mixture. It's a combination of ferrous oxide and ferric oxide. Okay, and this 8 by 3 we are getting by taking the average of the oxidation number of iron present in ferrous oxide and present in ferric oxide. That's why we are getting a fractional oxidation state. Okay, next we have CrO5, chromium pentoxide. Now if you follow the usual method, if we take oxygen as minus 2, then we are going to get oxidation state of chromium is plus 10, which is never possible, because chromium's oxidation state cannot go beyond 6. That means here all the oxygens, they are not present as oxides. Some of them are present as peroxides. So this is the structure of chromium pentoxide. Okay, where we are having two peroxide bonds. And if we calculate the charge right now, is if we calculate the oxidation state of chromium, then this will be taken as minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, here also minus 1, and this one is minus 2. See, right now if we calculate the oxidation state of chromium, we get plus 6. Okay, next, H2SO5. Here also, if we follow the usual method of calculating the oxidation number, then it is not possible. Because if we follow the usual method, then oxidation state of sulfur will be plus 8, which is not possible. That means here also some peroxide linkages are present. So if we draw the structure of H2SO5, that is Caro's acid, we get this one. Okay, now if we calculate, hydrogen is plus 1, this is this is minus 2, minus 2 here. This is your minus 1, minus 1, plus 1. If we calculate the oxidation state of sulfur, what do we get? It is basically plus 2 due to hydrogen, plus 2. Plus 2, then here minus 6, minus 6, minus 2, plus X equals to 0. So plus 2, minus 2 gets cancelled, X equals to plus 6. So by considering the peroxide linkage, we get the proper oxidation state. Here we have only one peroxide linkage. In chromium pentoxide, we had two peroxide bonds or two peroxide linkage. Now, last exception is H2S2O8. Here also, peroxide linkage is present. Let's draw the structure. Here also, we are having one peroxide linkage. And rest others are oxide. Okay, now if we calculate the oxidation state, what do we get? For hydrogen, we get plus 2. Then we have 6 oxides. So, 6 oxides, 6 to the so we get minus 12. Due to the peroxide, we get minus 2 plus 2x due to 2 sulfur equals to 0. Now plus 2 minus 2 gets cancelled. X will be equals to plus 6. Okay, now if we define oxidation and reduction in terms of the oxidation number, then what do we say? Oxidation is a process that involves increase in oxidation number, and reduction is a process that involves decrease in oxidation number. And if you want to define oxidizing and reducing agent, then oxidizing agent is a substance that undergoes decrease in oxidation number, and reducing agent is a substance that undergoes increase in the oxidation number. So that's it, class 11. Thank you.